What's up, everyone? This is Barbell, and welcome back to some more Skyrim action. I'm very glad to have you with me here today. And in this episode, as you can see, we are picking up precisely where we left off at the end of the last episode. And speaking of the last episode, things got wonky, especially towards the end. We had exploding mud crabs, we had crazy-ass seasoned hunters of ancient lore who were apparently invincible. Don't know how that happened, but he's dead, so that's pretty badass that we killed an invincible seasoned hunter of ancient lore. When there's lore and it's ancient, things are bound to get crazy. Speaking of bound, I also used a bound bow and bound battle axe. I recommend you guys check out that previous episode if you haven't seen it already. So what we need to do today is we need to approach the stank-ass Night Mother. Like I said towards the end of the last episode, I hope we can just talk to her outside of the coffin. I cannot take that smell any more than I have to. So let's travel on back. Oh, we also get to see the new Dawnstar Sanctuary crib, you know, upgraded. We purchased all the decorations, I think, 2 episodes ago, so we will get to see what it looks like now. Why is the quest marker way the hell over here? Is she just going out for a stroll? She's just sitting inside the inn at Dawnstar. She's just sitting at a table. Just the coffin is there. And every once in a while, it opens a little bit, and a mug just floats in, and the coffin closes. And then the coffin opens back up, and the mug comes back out completely empty. And everyone's just like, holy shit. This is creepy. We need to leave now. Alright, let's go to the Dawnstar Sanctuary. So you're the fellow who got the Sylvanar to sign all those contracts, said the second diplomat. That must have required some deep negotiation. If you know what I mean. What? Assault has started! Wait a minute, I haven't fully recovered from the last dragon fight. We fought a revered dragon, which is pretty cool. Oh, okay. He's gonna let me superpower up because he's attacking Dawnstar over there. That's perfect. And we got an alteration level up. We are only 8 levels away from getting 130, which means we can get the final perk for alteration spell duration. Pretty cool. Pretty cool. Also, I didn't hear if he was a fire or frost. I think I was half a second away from saying, I think fire. And then he blasts me with that weird ice pillar, that ice geyser. All right. Well, thanks for answering my question. Are you going to fight me, bro? He's kind of like, I'm just going to spook everyone with my loud dragon roar. Okay. Let's see if we can... Whoa, a little lag action there. Let's see if we can hit him with a little bit of the Kamehameha. A little bit. He got a taste. A dash. Oh, he got a little bit more. He got just enough to know he doesn't like it. Oh, it's only an elder dragon? We got this by the ass. I was going to say the elder ass, and then I realized what I was going to be saying, and I was like, ugh. Don't nobody want to say that. All right, you going to look at me? You looking? Look at this. Oh, God. You know, I don't think, how do I talk? I don't know. I haven't done it before. I was going to say, I think if I didn't get that breath ward up, I would have died right there. I was surprised at how powerful that frost attack was. I mean, being a Nord and all, having that frost resistance. Alright, please. Oh, don't you- Okay, I thought he was gonna land up there at the tower where the danger quest is. Whoa, whoa! He's got some weird flight patterns going on. Get grounded. Get grounded! Good, good. Another soul to add to my collection. Yeah! Taste the power, motherfucker. Wait a minute, what's going on? What's going on? Oh, I thought he just stopped taking damage for no reason. All right, well, I cut my own hype short. There we go. We blast him in the booty with a little... Oh, another incinerate. Blast him in the booty with some fire spells. That's cool, too. So, for me, I'm recording this episode immediately after the previous one. So, in the past about 10 minutes or so, I fought 2 different dragons. Pretty cool. Getting them souls. I will take and scale. And scale. I don't know if you guys have noticed, but whenever I kill a dragon, I always wait for the Dragon Soul Absorb text to come up before I loot it. Because I think a long ass time ago, there was one instance where a dragon died and I went to loot it before it said I got the soul, and I never got the soul. So ever since then, I wait. It's a new habit I've developed, I guess.
We need to do something about these vampire attacks.
Gets attacked by a dragon, he's like, yo, these vampires are a menace. I'm just like, what vampires?
Your ancestors wouldn't want this silence.
Don't care. Not my problem for now. We will do that quest at a later date. All I can tell you is that date is not today. So, as I mentioned, I'm recording this immediately after the previous one, which is a benefit of trying to do shorter episodes. I'm able to do more at one time. But that also means I still have yet to see any comments about what you guys think of the shorter episodes, because as of this point, I still haven't uploaded part 48. And I think I've asked in the previous two episodes, and I'm asking in this one, what you guys think of shorter episodes. I apologize if you've already responded once and you're wondering why I haven't seen it. It's because I haven't uploaded any of those episodes yet. But once again, for the final time probably, please post your thoughts in the comments about what you think about the shorter episodes, if you want. You don't have to, obviously. But I think it'll benefit everyone greatly. What is this? What are you doing? What are you doing? Why? Why, Cicero? Please explain why. And why do I hear people groaning in the background? What have I turned this place into? What have I done? I thought this was supposed to be a place for badass assassins to hang out. Instead, we got some crazy ass clown doing breakdancing moves in front of a corpse. Tell jokes about a horker. Why? Why do I associate myself with these people? What is this room? Alright, these are in fact the torture victims.
Anything. Just please stop hurting me.
Talk.
I just can't take the pain. Not a second longer.
The pain. I like how purchasing decorations includes these people. Oh. Alright, let's... Hey, we got the stained glass back.
Yes, listener. How may I serve you?
Oh, I didn't know you could command these people to follow you. Pretty neat. Hello!
Why am I not surprised to learn Cicero is alive? I still can't stomach the little clown. But if you've welcomed him here, I won't question it.
Damn right you won't question it.
And try not to get yourself killed.
Okay. Would you? Okay.
Yet another child.
Get out of here! I'm the listener. You're not. Go stand in your shame corner.
Speak with a nervous patron at Candle Hearth Hall in Windhelm. Accept his gold.
Get the hell out of here, Cicero!
Kill the target. So begins a contract bound in blood.
Oh god, that breath! Woo! That's rank. You know what? On second thought, go ahead. Inhale deeply while you're over there. Dude, he looks pissed heavy, doesn't he? He looks so mad! Wait a minute. A thought has occurred to me. Can we?
That's cute.
Oh, his head! Oh no! Oh, Cicero! Oh, man. Just straight up decapitate that fool with the Nightmother's coffin. Although, now that I think about it, that would probably be a way he would want to die. Like, he wouldn't be disappointed if he finds out in the afterlife when he goes to the Shadow Realm. He's like, hey, how did I die? Well, the Grand Archmage's Pimpus slash listener slash greatest assassin of all time kind of pushed you into the Nightmother's coffin and then chopped your head off with the doors of the coffin. So, yeah, he's like, whoa! I've never gotten so close to the Nightmother before. I am honored. And then he does his crazy-ass jester dance. That was obnoxious. I can't believe he was doing that. Alright, I guess. Well, I kind of joined the Thieves Guild so I could get closer to Disarm. You know what? Okay, we'll do this contract, and I think the next episode I will start the Thieves Guild proper. I don't like the Thieves Guild personally, especially since I'm not playing a sneaky character, if you guys can't tell. But I want Disarm pretty badly, and I'm not going to get Disarm if I keep putting off the Thieves Guild quests. So I think next episode we'll do Loud and Clear. You guys will see my top tier Thief gameplay, and you'll be super impressed. Super impressed. I mean, when you watch my Thief gameplay, you'll be getting all kinds of tips and tricks on how you should be thieving. Miniger put on the net okay, I didn't get to read that. Hopefully it wasn't super important. Quest marker over this door, but not over this one. So I'm gonna use this one. I'm such a rebel.
You got some nice meat. You, my
friend. What did you just say?
Damn good punch.
And I'm telling Bella's like, you've got some nice meat there. Who are you?
That's what you said the last time.
I could probably count on one hand how many times I've been in this inn in the entire time I've played Skyrim. I really do like the second floor though, now that I take a second to look at it. Nice high ceiling, it's got this fireplace right in the center. That's actually really cool. Who? Oh, is that the person who's still lying dead in the cemetery because I haven't started that quest? Why are you knocking baskets over, bro? Have some manners. What a basket case! Ah! Alright.
You're here. I was wondering if that black sacrament even worked. I need you to kill a poor fishwife on the Riften docks.
What the fuck? He's not like, I need you to kill some lady. He has to add in poor fishwife. Just to make it even sadder. Or I guess to make you feel even more guilty. I wish these quests were a little more interesting if they gave you just a reason why. And I also have to question why all the people who do the rituals and contact the Elder Gods, why they have to tell me about it in the middle of a packed inn, and they talk very loudly like, yo! Hey, Dark Brotherhood Assassin, over here! The guy waving his arms, I would like you to kill somebody for money, please! It's like, god damn, man, can't you be a little more secretive? Alright. Oh, he did say Riften, didn't he? Oh, this is perfect. It'll take us back to Riften and put us in a good spot to start the Thieves Guild quest in the next video. Perfect. Everything is going according to plan. By the way, some of you have asked before if I have Falskar installed. Falskar is a mod that adds a whole new area and quest and stuff, and yes, I do. You guys may recall that there was some loud-ass old guy who started blabbing. Well, excuse me, the first time I came to Riften. I haven't seen him since, though. Maybe he's in the Beam Barb, I'm not sure. Also, why am I getting a low frame rate in here? I know you. You don't know shit, man. Just keep walking, and everything will be fine. By the gourmet. Oh, we go out here? Okay. Very rarely use that door.
There are some that say the Dark Brotherhood is back and stronger than ever. That they've made Dawnstar their home. Tell me, am I wrong?
I wouldn't know, man. I don't meddle with those assassin types. They're crazy. You never know what they'll do for money. We might as well get this quest. From Deepest Fathoms!
You must take the lexicon. Free me of my burden.
Lexicon? Burden? What are you talking about? Lamp oil? Bombs? Rope?
The memories. I cannot stand them. You must take them away. Return them to a Munchenzel. You must take the lexicon from me. Please.
Hey, do you mind, lady? Now. Have you ever had that happen to you in real life when you're talking to somebody and they just some random person just walks in between you? It's like, come on, really? Really? I will take the lexicon.
You must bring it to Avanchenzel in the west.
Avanchenzel. Avalanche. Okay, thanks. Hey, you kind of smacked your head on the sign there. Those fish look awfully happy, don't they? They are just happy to be here. Okay. Where's the quest? Or the target, I should say. Outside somewhere. Whoa, another Argonian. Hello, who are you?
Please help me. I'm going to lose my job at the Riften Fishery. I really need your help. I don't want to lose my job at the fishery. What am I going to do?
Well, you're awfully bad at sweeping because I haven't seen a single leaf move yet. Do you like working at the Riften Fishery? I wonder. You might lose your job.
My job. Why? At the Riften Fishery is in danger. The owner, Bolly, said that if I show up for work in this condition one more time, then I'm out. I don't mean to do this to myself, but I can't help it. I tried some skooma a year ago, and ever since then, I can't stop.
God damn.
If you could give me a healing potion,
that's addictive.
I could cleanse this poison from my body and get back to my life.
Yo! You want some healing potions?
Your kindness will never be forgotten. Here, take this. It's all I can offer you for what you've given me.
Identify Riften Skooma Dealer?
It is our most favorite company.
What is a skooma? I don't know. Where do you get your skooma from?
Look, I don't think I should say. I mean, they could kill me.
I think you owe me one.
Okay, I'll tell you. I get my skooma from Sarthas Idrin. He has some sort of a setup over the Riften warehouse.
A word?
You can't get inside, though. They've kept that place locked up tight since the war began.
Who has the key?
I overheard Bolly say that only the Jarl carries the key to the warehouse. When I meet Sarthas there, he's usually waiting for me outside with his bodyguard.
What will you do now?
If it wasn't for skooma, I'd already be on my way out of this horrible city. All my gold, completely gone. Now I have to start over. I'll never use skooma again. Although I suppose a little mead now and then would be harmless.
Oh god, here we go again!
You've been kind. I thank you.
If I see her out here on the docks again, like, hey man, I'm kind of an alcoholic now. You got another health potion? I'd be like, nope, fresh out. Even though I've got all these delicious health potions. She'll never know.
Did you want something? I'm quite busy.
Wow, well.
It's yours now. I won't take it back. I won't.
Well, I'm not asking you to take it back. Please stop staring at me. I have to murder someone. Thank you. Okay, we're gonna definitely, we need to get her out of the sight of the guards. So, I'm sure you guys might get a feeling where I'm going with this. Ooh! Oh! Oh, she straight up got evaporated! Who saw that? Anybody see? Did you see? Uh-oh. Oh, God. Get the ashes! Quick! Put them in your pocket! Oh, no time! Kick them into the water!
Stop. Shouting is making people nervous.
I'm the Archmage of the College of Winterhold. Leave me at once, fool!
Whatever you say.
Damn right! Okay, we're good. Alright, now I have to sit here and wonder what should I do for the next 10 minutes. I guess I could always maybe start the Golden Glow Estate and then just resume it in the next video. Whoa, wait. We do have to turn this in, don't we? Maybe it'll give us another contract. Cicero, I swear to God, you better not be yucking it up in here again. No, don't you start another dance number. I will paralyze you, son. Where is it?
Yet another child has prayed to their mother. Speak with the unemployed laborer at the Frostfruit Inn in Rorikstead. Accept his gold and kill the target. So begins a contract bound in blood.
Hey, Cicero, what do you want to do today? Oh, damn it. God, I regret letting him in here. I regret it. I regret it completely. Wait. Have we even been getting rewards? Oh, wait, that's right. They pay us up front for the contract. Okay, well, I don't know how long these contracts are going to go on. I mean, it does say the Dark Brotherhood forever. I don't know. Well, I guess we'll do this one and see what happens. If you guys were wondering what I was laughing about when I went up to Cicero a couple times, every time he's like, let's kill someone. Let's kill someone. And then it figures when I go up to him, I'm like, hey, what do you want to do today? He just starts blabbing about something else. So that kind of ruined my joke that I was going for there. Thanks a lot, Cicero. Who'da thunk it? The jester ruins the joke. Rorikstead again? Are you serious? Rorikstead. I'm from Rorikstead. Again. Don't do it. You'll take an arrow to the knee. Ah! What is this? 2011? 2012? Arrow to the knee jokes? Say what? I'm bringing them back. You again?
So you're the one from the Dark Brotherhood?
Yes.
I need you to kill the big laborer at Catalyst Farm. Here's the gold for the kill. Make it painful.
Dark Brotherhood of the Traveling Shirt.
From the college.
Okay, so we have another target. Already outside. But where? I could probably know this instantly if I paid attention. Oh. Okay, Catla's Farm. So I guess while we clean up this last quest here and kind of get towards the end of the episode, I do have a question of the day for you guys. And it's currently October 10th. So I'm curious about your guys' thoughts about the return of The Walking Dead. Season 7, I believe, is starting later this month. Are you hyped or are you not hyped? Are you one of the people like me who absolutely loves the show, or have you gotten tired of it and don't really watch it anymore? Let me know what you think and how excited you are down in the comments below. Also, a side note, what do you think about Fear the Walking Dead? I watched the first season. I think I watched the majority of the second one. Has there been another season this year? I don't even know. I haven't heard anything about it this year. I don't know if there's been a third season. But, I don't know. That series, not great. Not great in my opinion. Hello.
Did it kill you to let a man go about his business in peace? Really, nerve.
It won't kill me, but it'll kill you. Alright, guys. I think we need to do another, I don't know. The suicidal mud crabs might damage these horses, and then we're really going to be in some trouble. Okay, here's what we're going to do. We're going to lure him into the dark alley. Fuck you. Wow, he dodged it? This dude dodged it? Oh my god, he's picking up an axe. He's ready to throw down, man. Or is he? Wait a minute, is he running? Nope, nope. Is anybody seeing this right now? Is anybody witnessing this nonsense? Nope. Nobody saw a thing. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. We got an enemy marker. Did I? Wait. Fire! It didn't say that I had a that somebody saw. He saw. Wait a minute, can I talk to you? Okay, I stopped. You don't have to get right up in my face about it. I have coin out the ass, man. Let's just make
smart
a deal.
Man. Now, come along with us. We'll take any stolen goods and you'll be free to go. After you pay the fine, of course.
Hey, man. If I can pay a fine and get away with murdering the Emperor's body double, pretty sure I can pay a fine and summon the entire Solitude City Guard, apparently.
Can I help our brother Nord?
I can pay a fine and get away with killing a... What was it? Big laborer? Okay, so we got another contract down. Let's fast travel on back to the Dawnstar Sanctuary and see what happens next. I mean, we've done three contracts now. Maybe that's it. Maybe there's more. If there's a fourth one, I'm going to say forget it. Because then it'll appear that they're just a never-ending radio quests. And it actually wouldn't surprise me, seeing as there's no story, no real dialogue. It's just, hey, here's coin, go kill, have a nice day. I like the coin. How much coin do I have? Ugh, 97k, I need more. But not this way.
Yet another child has prayed to their mother. Speak with the scheming servant at the keep in Margarth. Accept his gold, then eliminate the target. So begins a contract bound in blood.
Cicero is at your service.
Okay, you know what? Cicero, you can deal with the Night Mother for now. I'm about done with these contracts. We've got bigger and better things to do. More coin to collect. More words of disarm to learn. Is there anything out there? Don't know. Don't care, because you know what? It's the end of the episode. And it's roughly 30 minutes. I think a little short, but hey, trying to keep it around that 30 minute mark. So don't forget, guys, a lot of questions for you all. And you are more than welcome to participate in the comment section below. What do you think of the shorter episode times? What do you think about The Walking Dead returning? And what did you think about Fear the Walking Dead? Let me know. I love reading comments. I love interacting with you guys. So the more you post, the better. I'm going to end it here. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. And I will see you all in the next video for some more Skyrim action. Take care, everybody. Bye. That. Oh, he hit me! You bastard! He hit me and stunned me up!